Damn thing won't break. That one won't break. So flat will break after a fair amount of breaking, smashing. I have to get a density test, but pretty strong. So now I need to do waterproofing on this and add in sodium silicate. And as you can see in here, the mix is almost perfect. So we've got an aggregate in there, limestone flakes and flex, granite flakes and flex, but mainly limestone. You can see the granite, it's darker. And then we have kaolin clay, sodium carbonate, and clamshells. So yeah, I mean, dude, super strong. I mean, if you were doing this out of concrete and you were banging it as hard as I was just banging it, or glass or anything else, it would have shattered already. So it took some serious banging there for me to shatter that. This is one day cured. So here, let me. This is up at 5 feet. I mean, it's not breaking. So strong, it's real strong. Now, Texas A&M University just magically did a full study and released the study during COVID lockdown on a Zoom call. And they found out that their geopolymer that they made using metakaolin clay with an aluminum silicate in it, 90 megapascals, which regular concrete for bridges and roads is 32 to 40 megapascals, apparently. I didn't know anything about that, but. So it's about twice as strong as regular Portland cement, and the strongest cements in the world are like up to 200, and that's with all kinds of additives and fibers and stuff in it. So to get 90 megapascals on a just metakaolin clay, basically, with sodium carbonate and so forth, that's huge. That's a big deal. You can make, I would think you'd be able to make all kinds of stuff just without even the waterproofing, that you could do this for interior stuff in your house. Tiles, floor tiles, wall tiles, decorations, sculptures. And with the waterproofing, again with the sodium silicate in it, then you could start doing outside applications like outside bricks, driveways, structures, buildings, and have them last twice as long as concrete. I could see why they would want to keep that on the down low and on the wraps. Why they would want to stop people from doing that, I understand. I think because structures would last for just hundreds and hundreds and hundreds of years, as opposed to a couple hundred years, you'd have structures lasting thousands of years. And I don't know if they want that, whoever they are. But there it is again. So I'm going to mix this up. Let me show you. So this is out here in my garage. Sorry, I got a little mess going on here, but here's some of the granite little flakes that I put in just to strengthen it up. We've got silicate sand. We've got kaolin clay. I'm sorry, that's the limestone. That's powdered limestone, kaolin clay, and limestone flakes. And I also have graphene, copper, aluminum, zinc, and so forth to make the battery version of this. That, if you guys don't know, I several years ago discovered something that was huge, that you could generate power by using vitamins, inert materials like this, like solid materials, a solid state generator, basically something that generates power just out of a brick like this. But you can also paint it on paper and just generate the power on a piece of paper. But my idea is to do it in layers through the stone. So I have a layer, four layers, one of which is graphene right in the middle, and that this piece of stone can generate power all day long as you have the layers set in the stone in the right order. So my idea is to do zinc layer, copper layer, aluminum layer, graphene layer, and then attach a wire to it and pull power out of it all day long as it sits there and generates power all day long, with the layers set in stone like that. So yeah, that's a big thing too. I'll try that, see if it works. It might not work, but we'll try it. And this strong material, again, this is, I mean, a quarter inch thick right there. And I mean, I could get it to break. I mean, if this is cinder block, yeah, there we go. So if that was a cinder block piece, an inch thick, it would still break. If I just give it a couple bangs on a countertop, the cinder block brick would break. So this being a quarter inch thick like that and taking that much to break, I'm pretty impressed. I really am. And again, it's one day cured. So yeah, I'm going to play around with it a lot more. I'm going to do all kinds of stuff and I'm going to make my mixes for you guys. And I will be making an ashtray once I get the soda glass, or I'm sorry, once I get the water glass. I will make ashtrays to sell. Yeah. Preserve 3,000 years. We found it in the future. It must be some kind of ritualistic. No. Well, maybe it was ritualistic, but for people who smoke, seriously. Anyway, so that's just a bash test. I wanted to show everybody, this is a 7-minute long video now, but it's just me talking about breaking these things. Word up and much love, guys. Peace out.